Good morning, children. Welcome to the next video of Standard 6th, Kinds of Nouns, Grammar, Lesson number 3. Kinds of Nouns. So, children, we have studied about nouns. Am I right? Yes. Now, nouns means it is a naming word, name of a person, place, animal, or thing. Now, here we have to study the kinds of nouns. The basic 5 kinds of nouns we have to study. They are common noun, proper noun, collective noun, abstract noun, and material noun. Okay, let's start with common nouns. A common noun is a name given in common to person, place, animal, or things of the same class or kind. Example, Shylock was a moneylender. This dress is very colorful. There is a cow in the garden. Now, if I say I am going to temple, which temple do we come to know? No. It's temple includes all temples. Maybe Mahalakshmi temple, Ram temple, or any other temple. Yes? So, we have to do it. Understood? Ram temple, it may be any temple. But if I say that I am going to Lord Rama's temple, then you have to come to know that the temple is of Lord Rama. So, common noun is temple. Understood? Proper noun. Proper noun is the name of a particular person, place, animal, or thing. Proper name. He is Ram. Or the name of that boy is Ram. So, what is the name of that boy? Ram. So, proper noun. Shylock. Shylock is noun. Proper noun. Is name of a person. Japan is a country to the east of India. Japan and India are the name of the places. So they are proper nouns. My dog's name is Rover. Rover is name of the dog. So it is proper noun. I live near Diamond Park. Where do I live? Name of a park. Name of my residence. Name of my area. Diamond Park. So it is proper noun. And proper noun always begins with capital letter. Next is collective. Collective means group. A collective noun is a name given to a group or collection of people, animals, or places or things taken together as a whole means group. In short, you have to consider the group. The class was very silent. Class means lot of students are there. Then only the class becomes. So class of students. The class is collective noun. The shepherd looked after his flock of sheep. The group of sheep is called as flock. Flock is collective noun. The marble fell near a heap of stones. Group of stones are called as heap. So heap is collective noun. Next is abstract noun. Abstract noun means quality or a behavior. An abstract noun is a name given to quality, state, action, or feeling. She is known for her kindness. How is she? Kind. Kindness is a quality. Youth is a time for fun. Youth means state. It is a state. Youth, old age, young age. Yes? The room was filled with laughter. Action is there. Everyone was laughing. The young man lived with hatred in his heart. Hatred means it is a feeling. Hating. Yes? So, abstract noun. And last, that is material noun. Material noun, see? Name of a game given to material or a substance. Any substance it may be. Gold. Yes, milk. Milk. Gold. Silver. Anything. Cotton. The chain was made of gold. Gold is a material or substance. There was no milk in the bottle. The pillow is full of cotton. Now let's see the exercise. Underline the nouns in the following sentences. First, Arthur drew the sword from the stone. Just underline the nouns. Noun means names. It may be common noun, proper, any may. It may be, but it should be noun. Arthur, sword and stone. It has an important message for children all over the world. Message, children and world. Milo was a young boy who lived in San Francisco in the States. Milo, boy, San Francisco, and States are the nouns. They could present their projects through posters or exhibitor collection. Projects, posters, and collection. A committee of parents and teachers was set up. Committee is a group. Committee, parents, and teachers are the nouns. Antonio was a kind man whose best friend was Bassanio. Antonio, man, friend, and Bassanio is our nouns. A glint of steel caught his eye. Steel and eye are nouns. India has immense knowledge in veterinary sciences. India, knowledge, and sciences are the nouns. You will be fascinated by my cultural heritage, beautiful palaces, and historical temples. Heritage, palaces, and temples are the nouns. He bowed his head in deep devotion. Head and devotion are the nouns. In same way, you have to do the remaining part of this lesson. Question. See the second question. They have given the sentences and they have given one table. Proper, common, collective. Proper, common, collective, abstract, and material. You first read the sentence, underline the nouns, and put that nouns in proper groups. I have solved first four questions for you. Akbar had a very strong army. Here, Akbar and army are the nouns. Now, Akbar. Akbar is name, so it will come in proper noun. And army means collection, group. So it will come in collective noun. Second is, he had great respect for scholars. Respect is a quality. So it is abstract noun. Respect will come in abstract noun. And scholars will come in common noun. We don't know the name of that scholars. Next, we never spill any ink. Ink is a noun and ink is name of a liquid or substance. So ink is material noun. Here it will come in material form. Next. We have got 10 centuries for our production. Centuries. Common. We don't know the name of that centuries. So centuries will come in common noun. Understood? In similar way, you have to complete the remaining part of the lesson. Okay. So in next video, we'll meet with next lesson.